Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is a new day. We will be reading from the book of Habakkuk, chapters 1 through chapter 3. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this day, for this moment, and to be able to serve you and your people. I'm just honored to be alive. I'm honored to be able to try again, to give it one more shot at my dreams on this day. So before I even get to any of that, I got to get my reading in for the day. So we'll be reading Habakkuk chapters 1 through 3. And it's so amazing for me reading the Bible. I'm learning about books I'd never even heard about. You know, we keep it simple. We keep it simple with the Genesis and the Revelations and the Matthew and the John. But hearing things like Nahum and Habakkuk and even learning the stories of Esther, that's what this is about. Learning things you ain't never learned before. So I don't want to take up too much more time. Let's get into it. Chapter 1. Habakkuk's question. The burden which Habakkuk the prophet did see. O Lord, how long shall I cry, and thou wilt not hear? Even cry out unto thee of violence, and thou wilt not save? Why didst thou shew me iniquity, and cause me to behold grievance? For spoiling and violence are before me, and they are that raise up strife and contention. Child, it's already good. It's already good. Let me grab a pen, though. Verse 4. Therefore, the law is slacked, and judgment doth never go forth. For the wicked do compass about the righteous. Therefore, wrong judgment proceed. The Lord's answer. Behold ye among the heathen, and regard and wonder marvelously. For I will work a great work in your days, which ye will not believe, though it be told you. For lo, I raise up the Chaldeans, that bitter and hasty nation, which shall march through the bread of the land to possess the dwelling places that are not theirs. They are terrible and dreadful. Their judgment and their dignity shall proceed of themselves. Their horses also are swifter than the leopards, and are more fierce than the evening wolves. And their horsemen shall spread themselves, and their horsemen shall come from far. And they shall fly as the eagle that hastes to eat. They shall come all for violence, and their faces shall sup up as the east wind, and they shall gather the captivity as the sand. And they shall scoff at the kings, and the princesses shall be a scorn unto them. And they shall deride every stronghold, for they shall heap dust and take it. Then shall his mind change, and he shall pass over, and if offend, imputing this his power unto his God. Another question for Habakkuk. Art thou not everlasting? Art thou not from everlasting? O my Lord God, mine Holy One, we shall not die. O Lord, thou hast ordained them for judgment. And Almighty God, thou hast established them for correction. And thou art of pure eyes than to behold evil and cannot look on iniquity. Wherefore lookest thou upon them that deal treacherously, and hold thy tongue when the wicked devour the man that is more righteous than he? Question. And make men as the fishes of the sea, as the creeping things that have no ruler over them. question. They take up all of them with the angle they catch them in their net and gather them in their drag. Therefore, they rejoice and are glad. Therefore, they sacrifice unto their net and burn incense unto their drag, because by them their portion is fat and their meat plenteous. Shall they therefore empty their net and not spare continually to slay the nations? I'm going to repeat that. That was verse 17. Shall they therefore empty their nets and not spare continually to slay the nations? Chapter 2. Habakkuk awaits the Lord's prayer. Answer. Habakkuk awaits the Lord's answer. And I will stand upon my watch and set upon the tower and watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am reproved. The Lord's answer. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run that read it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time. But at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him. But the just shall live by his faith. Yea, also, because he transgressed by wine. He is a proud man. Neither keep at home, who enlarged his desires as hell, and is as death, and cannot be satisfied. But gathered unto him all nations, and heaped unto him all people. Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a taunting proverb against him, and say, woe to him that increase that which is not his, how long? And to him that laid himself with thick clay, shall they not rise up suddenly, that shall bite thee, and awake that shall vex thee, and thou shalt be for booties unto them? Because thou hast spoiled many nations, all the raiment of the people shall spoil thee, because of men's blood, and for the violence of the land, of the city, and of all that dwell therein. Woe to him that cover an evil covetousness to his house, that he may set his nest on high, and that he may deliver, and that he may be delivered from the power of evil. So there is such thing as a power of evil. Okay. In verse 10, thou hast consulted shame to thy house by cutting off many people, and hast sinned against thy soul. For the stone shall cry out of the wall, and the beam of the timber shall answer it. Woe to him that build a town with blood, and establish the city by iniquity. Behold, is it not the Lord of hosts that the people shall labor, and the very fire, and the people shall weary themselves for very vanity? For the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Woe unto him that give his neighbor drink, that puttest thy bottle to him, and make him drunken also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. Thou art filled with shame for glory. Drink thou also, and let thy foreskin be uncovered. The cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee, and the shameful spewings shall be on thy glory. For the violence of Lebanon shall cover thee, and the violence of the beast, which made them afraid because of the men's blood, and for the violence of the land of the city, and all that dwell therein, would profit the graven image that the maker thereof had given it, the molten image, and a teacher of lies, that the maker of his work trust therein, to make dumb idols? Woe unto him that said to the wood, awake, to the dumb stone, arise. It shall teach. And behold, it is laid over with gold and silver, and there is no breath at all in the midst of it, but the Lord is in his holy temple, and let all the earth keep silence before him. Habakkuk's prayer. A prayer of Habakkuk, the prophet, upon Shigionoth. O Lord, I have heard thy speech and was afraid. O Lord, revive thy work in the midst of thy years. In the midst of the years, make known. In wrath, remember mercy. God came from Teman and the Holy One from Mount Paran. Selah, his glory. I always hear this word, Selah. I'm from this other man, so I gotta look that up. Selah, his glory covered the heavens, and the earth was filled of his praise, and his brightness was as the light. And he had horns coming out of his hand, and there was the hiding of his power. And there was the hiding of his power. Before him went the pestilence, and the burning coals went forth as his feet. He stood and measured the earth, and beheld and drove asunder the nations, and the everlasting mountains were scattered. The perpetual hills did bow, and his ways are everlasting. I saw the tents of Kashan in affliction, and the curtains of the land of Midian did tremble. Was the Lord displeased against the rivers? Was thine anger against the rivers? Was thy wrath against the sea, that thou did ride upon thine horses and thy chariots of salvation? Thy bow was made quite naked, according to the oaths of the tribes, even thy sword, Selah. Thou did cleave the earth with rivers, and the mountains saw thee, and they trembled. The overflowing of the water passed by. The deep uttered his voice and lifted up his hands on high. The sun and the moon stood still in their inhabitation. At the light of thine arrows they went, and the shining of thy glittering spear. Thou did march through the land in indignation, and thou did thresh the heathen in anger. And thou went forth for the salvation of thy people, even for the salvation with thine anointed. And thou woundest the head out of the house of the wicked, by discovering the foundation unto the neck. Selah. Thou did strike, though, through with his staves, the head of his villages. They came out as a whirlwind to scatter me. Their rejoicing was as to devour the poor secretly. Thou did walk through the sea with thine horns, through the heap of great waters. When I heard, my belly trembled, my lips quivered at the voice. Rottenness entered into the bones, and I trembled in myself, that I might rest in the day of trouble. When he come up into the people, he will invade them with his troops. Although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall the fruit be in the vines. the labor of the oil shall fail, and the field shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet will I rejoice in the Lord, and I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord is my God. The Lord is my strength. And he will make my feet like hen's feet. And he will make me to walk upon my high places to the chief singer on my stringed instrument. And that is the end of the reading today. Three things that caught my attention. This was good today. I have to say that. Chapter 1, verse 12. Art thou not from everlasting? O Lord, my God, mine Holy One, we shall not die. O Lord, thou hast ordained them for judgment, and Almighty God, thou hast established them for correction. That caught my attention. Thou hast established them for correction. Second thing that caught my attention. In chapter 2, the Lord answers in verse 2. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain unto upon tables, that he may run that read it. To me right there that says, you know, I'm going to let you figure out what that says, because we all going to feel something different. But that says a lot to me. And then continuing into verse 3, for the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it surely will come and it will not tarry. Chapter 2, verse 9 also caught my attention. While it says, woe to him that cover an evil confectionist to his house, that he may set his net on high, his nest on high, that he may be delivered from the power of evil. Sometimes I have to remember that evil is a thing. Enemies are a thing. An adversary is necessary for your growth sometimes. Don't look at it like this, like it's here to hurt you. But maybe that test is for your greater good, you know. So that is the ending of the reading today. My apologies for my voice and, you know, how I sound. I am a little stuffed up. And it's like so much going on. But I'm getting it on through. And I just want to say thank you, God, again. I love you guys, and I'm out.
You can't be everything to everybody. I want to be your lover, your best friend, your Batman, Spider-Man. Fight the pilot, shooting out your rivals, and I want